Hello and welcome to episode 70 of the Spare Change Challenge. It's here on a Free Money Friday. And we're going to try and run it up today. Hopefully the games are good. And hopefully we run good. And make a push toward 100 and L. Wouldn't that be sweet? Episode 70. Have a good session and make 100 and L. So we're coming off a pretty good session. We'll try and build on that today. That would be good. But yeah, all we can do is play our hands, table select, and just see what happens. So there's a possibility I'll play tomorrow night. Not sure yet. We'll see. I'll let you know tomorrow afternoon if that's the case. We're getting started a little bit early today. I'd like to be done by probably 4:30 or so to make dinner for the kids. And all that good stuff. Maybe play some Nintendo. Who knows? So we pick up our favorite hand on the button here. Limp and I ISO. Go ahead. Go ahead. Nah, don't raise. Okay. Yeah, I think we'll just fold this, just get away from our hand. This board is way too draw heavy. I was going to bet if you check, because I think it's slightly plus EV, but yeah, I'm just fine with just giving up. If you're going to give up on a board, that's probably a good one to do it on. This guy hasn't played a hand yet in four hands, so I'm just going to get off this table. Go ahead and cut my losses, move on, find a better spot. I'm sure there's plenty of them on a Friday. We're not going to mess around today. This is the primo day to play poker, so we're going to be very nitty with our table selection. We're going to just jet first time sign of a table not being decent and move on to greener pastures. This one right here is not shaping up to be a good table, so we're going to preliminarily click that. Not sure yet here. We'll wait one more time around here to be sure. I think we can check this back. Yeah, I think this is fine. This connects really well with his range. He's not going to fold an ace high. I just don't want to barrel off when we probably don't have showdown value versus most of his calling range, so I think it's okay against this type of player to do that. We will bet the queen high here on a 6-6-2, however. Yeah, on Fridays I think the optimal strategy is honestly just to table select, look for the big fish that are surely going to be out here somewhere. I haven't seen them yet. And just kind of play a little bit tight, maybe. It's tighter. And try and get in a lot of spots with the fish. If we can find any. But it's early. I'm sure there are some out here. This guy's 140. That's promising. Well, he's not 100 anymore. Okay, so he's deciding to fold two straight hands. A little bit of normalization going on, maybe. Not even sure this guy's a fish, actually. we'll get off of this shoddy looking table. Where's my fish? Maybe they're here. Or not. I think we were on this table, but I have to check. The old 76ers. Wow, this is not a great table either. Yeah, we're just gonna fold. Another shoddy table. Hope this isn't one of those days where we just table select and never find any kind of fish. I think we have the best hand most of the time for sure now. I think we just check call this river. I don't think he necessarily calls with a 10 anyway. Yeah. So he's not even betting an ace, so we have to check call. Just in case he's got some kind of bluff in his range. Wow, these tables, terrible today. Yes, it's pretty redonkulous. I don't know. Maybe this guy could be not very good. I don't know. This guy's 60-20. Maybe we'll play one more time around. I don't know. It's kind of slim pickings right now, so we can't just... We'll have zero tables up here in a minute. I don't want to switch to Sit and Ghost because it's supposed to be like a really great day for cash games normally. So we'll see. Maybe as the day wears on, it'll get better and better. That's usually the case, right? Wish we could play at night. Welcome to those just joining the stream. Yeah, what happened to our tables are just full of a bunch of passive people limping. Where's that at today? This is playing like 400 and L or something, I don't know. Of course, those games usually build around a whale, a fish. I don't know what these games are, just a bunch of regs grinding against each other. This guy's 44-0 over 9, so maybe we'll stay here for a moment. It's kind of like the table of the day right there. Yeah, this one probably is not good either. It's not good to be card dead and have bad table selection. We're going to dump a whole bunch of money here before we even play a hand. Yuck. No thank you, Doyle. Crikey.
Oh, crikey!
Okay. Boring, boring, boring. We're gonna bet on this board. A little bit small so we can get value from worse. And whatever. blah blah. Yeah, makes the fold easier. SPR's 3, so we're definitely committed. We just want to keep some hands in the range that we're beating. By betting, we're basically, I mean, I guess 6-8. Getting value from. This guy's pretty passive. I think we just call here. It's not the worst card in the world. It does set up some chop opportunities in case we're beat here. I think honestly we just check back. And now we can go for some value. Looks like he might have picked up a pair, like a queen or a nine, and that's what he's thinking about calling with. He's certainly going to call with a queen or a nine here. I don't see him folding. So I like our bet sizing. I think he could fold to a shove. He certainly could just have a weak ace. I think he already called by now if he had that. So maybe he had like a 7 or a 5 there. I don't know. Or it could have just been a missed flush draw. I'm not sure what he's doing there. Saving face maybe. I don't know. Once again, welcome to those just joining in our struggle to find good tables. San Francisco. So we have back doors, and we certainly just would rather win the pot right now. So we're going to bet pretty big. This guy's kind of short. I think we'll just check back. I think we bet. Just because we have 10 high, and if we can get him off queen high or better, now we're just going to bet for value. Wow, that's a weird call. Maybe just has a weak jack? I'm not folding. I mean, I think we're good often enough. He probably could show up with like a hand like, I don't know, King X here. Yeah, I mean, he had two pairs, so we're beat anyway. So, I mean, that's basically like a check. All he did was min bet. So, we'll just put it in here. I guess we'll get off this table. Guy's tanking on our shove here. So I assume he has a hand like king, queen, king, jack, a weak ace, small pair. Yeah, I mean, that certainly fits the criteria. Once again, disappointing. We can't just hold. We get the bad call, but we can't get the good win. But it's early, small pot. We'll keep grinding. Certainly a decent seed here if this guy's calling that wide. I mean, it's close. I mean, in a vacuum, I certainly might call with that hand against a fish. I mean, what I think might be a fish, a perceived fish, because I'm short. Wow, this guy open shoves 100 big blinds. So either he's on tilt or he's an idiot. So, well, hope this guy's just a maniac and going to keep doing that. And we'll profit from it. I think we'll limp this if it actually folds to us, which didn't happen. So we'll just bet because we probably have the best hand. Pick up a diamond draw. That's good. And now we'll just check the side. Yeah, that certainly sucks that he hit his miracle turn card. Why is he calling the flop? I don't know. But he's certainly fishy. He fished and he got there. A bit a little big here. This makes our decision a little bit easier. We certainly can get value from worse. Winning all the small pots, losing all the big ones so far. That's not good. We'll keep on pounding. Looks like we might have a couple fish here. We'll see. I think we can check this one back. We just played a pot with this guy. I don't think we can fold here. Is it worth hands that'll get it in, like 6x, spade draws, worse 8s? It's hard to have a worse 8 there, isn't it? Yeah, I think we just look for a safe turn card. That's not very safe, is it? Probably one of the worst turn cards. Yeah, I think it's okay to get it in on that flop. Was that the guy that shoved a little bit ago? I don't know what this guy could have besides King Jack, but if he just turned, yeah, that's pretty sick. If he just turned a gut shot on us. I think we just have to put it in. I mean, shit, he could be slow playing aces here, you know? Or king 10, and then get there. I don't know, man. What's up with us? We can't win at showdown. My god. Holy cow, he had like 2 6 outs. We had 87% equity there, I think. It's hard to do much better than that, you know? What was he thinking? We lead on a 9-9-10, and he's just going to go all the way when an overcard hits. Yeah. I mean, we like that, right? We like that. At least it was a small pot again, but still, we want to win pots. We don't want to lose pots. Let's get this shit out of our system. We need to be moving forward. I want to get to 100 and L. What's the big hold up here? Variance? Mr. Variance? I don't like you, Mr. Variance. Shit. Yeah, this guy's just always got it here. We'll check fold this hand. This guy was insta-folding, so we're basically in a three-way pot. There's still too much connecting with this board. We're just gonna, nothing's folding for one bet. right? This guy's pretty dumb here, so we're just gonna put it in with the ace 10. I mean, he called with ace 9 earlier, so I expect he's gonna call with king, queen, king, jack. A lot of hands we're just crushing right now. Or he could just have the nuts, you know? So I guess the poker god just let us have a little bit of a makeup there. It's a weird session, man. Get it in bad, we win. Get it in good, we lose. It's okay. It all averages out, I guess, in the end. It's pretty funny. I'm going to defend here. He's a tight-looking player, but I have king 3 suited. It plays pretty good heads up in position. I'm going to raise this flop just because I want to get rid of... I just want to make my decision easier. I think if I just call, it gets a little murky on the turn. I'd rather raise fold now than call, you know. He's not the type of player who's just going to bluff three streets, so probably not. So we're going to target this guy. All right, that's a good flop. It's a weird spot. It's not really a weird spot, but it's an interesting spot here. I don't mind just getting it in, obviously. But this guy looks pretty aggressive, and I think we can just have the best hand here. And I honestly think we could just call the turn and river and be good. But we're certainly not going to call this. We're just going to make this hand play easier. It's kind of a big... Yeah, I think we'll do a small raise. Small raise is better. And then call a shove. And this will give us the opportunity to check back some flops. Because I think once he calls here, he's probably got a king or a flush draw most of the time. And I think, obviously, I think he folds a king on this turn a lot. So I don't really want to bet here. I want to check back and give him a chance to be confident with his king on the river. Or maybe hit a worse flush. Or mitigate when he has a hand like ace-king or something. I don't know. Of course, he probably just gets that on the flop. So we almost always have the best hand. Hopefully, he just bluffs here. And we can pick it off. We're not raising because I don't think we're getting called by worse if we raise. So yeah, we got a little more value out of his king. I think he just folds that on the turn if we bet, so I like my line there. I think we maybe... I mean, the only way we get more out of him is if we ship the flop, and we just don't know if he's going to call with king 9 if we raise and ship... I mean, if we ship the flop. Yeah, Mr. V. We don't like Mr. V. This guy has 50-50, but it's only over four hand. We're going to be a nit. If this guy was in the cutoff, we would be putting the money in right now. But he's not. He's in the hijack. Hey, we're going to leave this table up a little bit. After that fiasco hand. I think we're leaving this table. I don't know. No, we're not. This guy's 129. I just realized that hand earlier I had. Dumb. This guy's obviously kind of dumb and, well, not, well, maybe dumb, but kind of just a bad player, so. We don't want to be leaving this table, even though he's on our left. He's 100 VPIP over seven hands. So, but I don't remember what that hand was earlier that I played against him, but I think I misplayed it with the preliminary read I have. So yeah, whatever. I think the only hand he raised was the open shove under the gun when we first sat at the table. This is like the perfect guy to raise big with a strong hand and then commit on any flop. I mean, I'm talking King Jack plus, Ace 10 plus, you know, any pair pretty much. Well, we have an SPR4 here with a three-way. I guess we just have to just bet, protect our hand. I mean, actually, this guy only has $7, so this guy's gonna have a fairly tight range. Well, not necessarily. I'm in raise, so just gonna bet and commit. Okay. Only thing that just got there was 5-6, really. If he has that, he has that. But I think flush draws might call here, 8-9. Something like that. I'm going to limp. Well, no, I'm not going to limp. I'm going to bet $3 and commit any flop here versus this guy. So this guy leads into me here. I think we just raise and shove the turn. Because we have two overs and a gut shot. I think it's profitable to do this. Wow. Okay. So he might have a heart draw here and we're good. Or he could just have a 10 and he'll fold the turn. Or if he has a jack, we have a lot of outs. Yeah, that sucks. He called it off with a 10. He's supposed to fold a 10 there on the turn. That's pretty bad. Bad for me. I think we get to give this guy some rope. All right, now we just bet and try to get in over two streets. Crap. All right, well, I mean, we got to put a ton of money in pre-flop, so can't really complain. I think we just min-raise now. Really? You're just going to shove? I just don't know. He hasn't 3-bet yet. I guess we'll fold now. We're going to get to see it anyways. This guy's got a tighter range than Ace 10 suit. I was actually going to consider a call here. I'm guessing his range, this guy is something like King Jack plus, Ace Jack plus, and any pair above sevens to do this. And this guy's range is like Ace Jack suited plus, probably Ace Queen and tens plus to call. Nines at the worst. Wow, Jack 8. Okay, it's better. Please win. Come on, fish. Damn. I'm going to sit out because unless this guy is going to reload, I'm not staying on this table. Damn it. We wanted this guy to win. I was certainly right. My hand was good. Why can't we win in those spots? God dang it. Try this seat. Two overs and I got shot with maybe the best hand. I'm gonna check this back. He could certainly have a worse Like, a hand like, I don't know. I mean, we try to get him off something here. Like a chop. I don't think so. I mean, yeah. I mean, probably doesn't even fold that. But I mean, I could see us like overbetting double pot there, just to try to get him off. Cause I think that's actually the play. Cause there's no way he's not chopping. There's no way he's winning there, right? So we have to get him off a chop. So, yeah. Why did I act so fast? If I had just talked my way through that hand, I would have done the right thing. Oh, well, that's what you get. Playing fast. Yeah, I'm definitely shoving this. This guy's 50-18. I doubt he has a pair better than mine. It's possible. This guy never has anything. He's just trying to play a pot with this guy. I love it when these little things happen. People get into these wars where they want to min-raise back. Threes, yeah. Confident in your threes, huh? This guy's got a tight range, but I still think we have the best hand here. If he raises, though, I'll fold. He's just too tight. 30 hands, he's played two hands now. I think this guy's definitely on tilt a lot. I'm just going to shove. Right, we're way ahead of his range here. We should be way ahead of his range. So let's shove and hope this guy doesn't pick something up. Well, wow. He just has to have an ace, right? Can we get there? We cannot get there, and he hits a straight. We have a dollar left. Yeah, that's unfortunate. I think he's going to call with like a lot of worse hands that we're crushing, so... I think we'll wait. But we like playing against this guy for sure. Maybe I should have been a little more patient, but I mean, we kind of got worst case scenario there, and we still were basically flipping, so. I think he's going to show up with like queen jack there, queen 10, king 10. Or it could fold. You know, that's a possibility too. I mean, this doesn't look like the type of guy that likes to fold. But he could. He could fold a hand like ace-8. Should be. But I think if we compared his overall raising range after that and the dynamic we had versus his calling range, king-jack is definitely a slam dunk plus EV play. It's just unfortunate we can't hit a pair. This guy's 100-100 over two hands. I guess that's too small of a sample. Really? The guy leaves. This is funny here. I'm not going to play heads up, I don't think. And I'm probably going broke anyways on this hand, so if he doesn't sit out first. We got him dominated. Don't you do it. He did it. Oh my god. That did not, I mean, this guy had like 3% equity, didn't he? On the flop? I mean, I'm not playing, I'm not going to reload anyway, but I just want to run this guy's equity on the flop. He was about as close as you can get to run it to a drawing dead. I mean, it's only a dollar, I'm not really worried about it, but I am curious to see how bad we actually run. I mean, at least that wasn't a big pot, you know? At least that's not a big pot. Yeah, I'm definitely leaving this one. Let me get a couple tables up before... Well, actually, let me just go ahead and put this in. I'm just curious, just for fun. So you had Jack 9 of spades. Maybe I'm way off base here. I had Queen 10 of spades, and the flop is 7 of spades, Queen of clubs, 5 of spades. Yeah, he had 4% equity on that flop. 4%, dude. That is unbelievable that we could lose that flop. I mean, we could lose this hand. Even though he got, like, one of his best turn cards, I still think he didn't have much equity on the turn because he had dirty outs. He jumped to 13% and we lost. I mean, that's almost as bad as getting beat by, like, flopping set over set and then losing to quads. That's almost as bad. Not quite, but almost. Actually, it might be as bad, right? Because if you have one out, that's 2% twice. So that's 4%. So that's just like losing getting quadded for set over set. That's how unlikely that is. But it was a dollar, so F you, dude. Imagine if we had been a big pot and we had got it on the flop there and losing that one, right? That would have sucked. Sucked hard. Okay. Good spot. And we hold. Wow. Good deal. How in the hell are we at over almost, we were almost $700 before the session. How the hell have we got there? Because we've had, how many, you guys that have been watching since the beginning, how many sessions have we had just like this? It seems like half of them have been like this or worse. It seems like we just never run good. Very seldom. It seems like we just have a few here and there, like we'll run good two or three sessions in a row, but then we'll just go 10 sessions running bad, you know. Is that just, I mean, I know that's the way poker can be, and I know it's completely random and there's nothing you can do about it, but it just seems like we are very fortunate to be where we are. So I'm saying this in a positive light, right? I'm not shining this in a negative light. I'm just feel very fortunate to be where we are right now. Yeah, if somebody's got Jack 10 here, good hand, sir. You could just as more likely have king queen, right? Or is there more combinations of jack 10? But regardless, I'm not checking back this flop because we don't want to see a jack or 10, right? It's just one of those boards that probably we're just going to get fold. We're going to bet half pot, so maybe a king or a queen can continue. Yeah, it's just the way that's going to go most of the time. But we won. We'll move on. We got the Jimmy James hand here. It's not my favorite hand, but I like it. I'm not one of those people that hates jacks. I love jacks. They're one of my biggest winning hands, right? It's one of my biggest winning hands. Not getting tricky. Don't fold. You're raising, aren't you? Aren't you? Yep, he is, isn't he? I'm gonna let him have this one. Can't really. I mean, that's the kind of board that I could check back against this type of player and then raise any turn. Kind of do a reverse raise on him. I don't know what you would call it. Kind of reverse his thought process there. And yeah, I actually considered it briefly before I bet, but I figured whatever. Just play straightforward on this hand, and maybe if that situation comes up, we'll play it differently next time. Yeah, this type of player, when he tank raises, it's normally a bluff, I think. On the first hand. Welcome to those just joining. Have a little run good for the jumpster here. Little run good. We don't need a lot, just a little. This table doesn't look great. Okay. Could have made this a family pot with the jack deuce suited. Shove. I mean, he could shove almost any two here. Jack deuce for the win. Fold or raise, come on. Slow poke. Wow. The whole table. Certainly not folding for one bet on this board. Okay. I guess you got it, don't you? Just leave this table. Yeah, I'm thinking check fold on this. All the dirty outs, reverse implied odds, all that crap. This guy's pretty aggro, so I think a min raise is better than a limp. Kind of a worthless gut shot. I mean, it's not completely worthless, but we do have the flush draw. We have to bet because that's what we do. Is the limp raise coming here? Maybe they know something I don't know. That's why they folded. So we'll leave this one now. Wow, okay. Are we ever getting a fold on this board? We have to bet though, turn our hand to no bluff. Because he's like always betting the turn, right? I guess we're just going to try and hit a flush here. We have the right price, so. Whatever. We'll give up here. Could sometimes have the best hand, just unlikely. Yeah, I mean, it's not like we're super likely to get value if we hit our flush now. We're only getting 3 to 1. And we don't know that a jack's live, so we'll just fold. Guy's a little bit. I mean, this board connects way too well with hands that could be betting for value there, so. Whatever. Think this might be a little loose. I had high hopes for today. I mean, it's not over yet, obviously, but. It seems like it's heading down the path of one of those typical run like ass days. We're getting bad situations mostly, and then running bad when the money goes in as well. So far, but it could, you know, this could be, it could go exactly the opposite from here on out, or it could just be average. We just don't know the future, right? So that's why we have to keep playing. Don't win anything by not playing. Think this is maybe a little too loose. I'd like to open it. So I have this guy, but. I'll be a little patient. I said I was going to do that, right? I don't know if I've been doing that this session. I think I've just been, maybe just been playing my normal game instead of. Of course, at the same time, the games don't look exactly super fishy, so maybe that's fine anyway. We've seen a couple fleeting fish that have either gone broke quick or just disappeared quickly. Wish we could get Mr. Shove a lot back with his Jack 8 shoves. Yeah, if Mr. Ace King doesn't pick up Ace King that hand, we would have doubled up. This guy's playing too many pots. I'm gonna have to tighten up my cutoff here. In fact, I'm leaving this table. What am I talking about? I mean, this is pretty strong normally, but we're not under the gun. We don't gonna consider folding here. I don't know. I mean, it's such a small sample, and these are short stacks. I think we could be good here often enough. I still think this is. They both could have ace king or whatever, or one could have queens. That sucks. Oh well. I'm not sure. I'm not gonna fold when an 80-20 does that. I mean, he doesn't have to have queens there. I mean, we would have lost anyway to this guy, so I guess it doesn't even matter, right? But still, it sucks. It was a triple up opportunity. I bet a little big here. Just makes me a lot more confident in my fold. And we can certainly keep getting value from worse aces. Leaving this table. Yeah, I'm just going to let this 5611 have this one. Shows us fives. Okay, we got the king, queen, and the big blind here. It's a pretty, pretty hand. I think this is plus EV. Hopefully this guy isn't just on some kind of heater here. Wow. Not a good turn. Not a good river. We'll dump another buy-in. King queen offsuit, I think, is just a flat there, but I think suited we have to put it in. I mean, he's gonna be, we would suspect isoling fairly wide there. I mean, it's kind of a vacuum play. We only have had five hands on the guy, so apparently this hand's gonna, this table's gonna break. Man, this guy's just picking up big hands. So this guy's sitting out, we're just gonna leave. Man, what a day. One hell of a day. I think this guy can ISO wide, so I think limping sevens here is okay. I don't know about this guy. I still think he can just have big cards here when he does this. He doesn't have to have a pair better than mine. It's kind of a cooler if he has eights plus. And he might fold eights or nines here. Not necessarily, but I think sometimes he will. It just looks like we have aces here a lot. He might just make a tight fold. Ugh, hopefully this is ace king. It's not really the guy I was targeting when I limped, but I kind of have to just go with it. How about a heart on the turn to make this an easy one? All right, we'll take a win. We'll take a win. It's like best case scenario for us there. I mean, sure, that looks like a bad ship by me, but think about it. This guy, even though he's 15-12, he's in the cutoff, he's in a steal position. I mean, he could just be an opportunist and be looking for a spot to raise and play a pot in position against what he might perceive to be a fish, because I'm short and I limped. So he could have Jack 10, Queen Jack, any Broadway really, any pair, and of course the nuts. So I think it's still fine. We could debate that, I guess. But he certainly was not the player I was targeting when I limped. Wow, no games. This is going to be one of those sessions where we're down like a whole bunch in EV too. Because the only time we're winning is when we win one behind and we're getting it in bad some too. I think this is just plays itself here. We're just going to take our top pair and open ender and just put it in. We pick up some outs. I think we just barrel off here with the king high. It's a good result. I mean, we have top pair. Obviously, we don't mind getting it in versus a worse hand, but it's just kind of hard to do that, right? When we have the nine. So we actually like a fold. We'd much rather have that than see somebody with jacks. And we also get two ranges off of hands that potentially have a ton of equity against us, like over cards. I don't know. Pick your poison. Gut shots. Not that Yeah, I mean, I guess. Anyway. I don't know what I'm really talking about here. I mean, I had top pair and open-ended. It's not like that's hard to play. But I'm just saying, you have to consider everything, right? It's the only way you get better at this game. Have to kind of doubt everything you do. Because there might be a better way. You never know. If there's a better way, I want to know about it. This doesn't look like maybe the greatest table, but whatever. Could have a hidden gem on it. Hidden gem, that's me. Because we're anonymous. Yeah, we'll raise that. No read, we fold. So this table looks good. I mean, these guys are tight, but that's okay. We have fish here, fish here. We shall stay. This one don't know yet. This one we're leaving. Probably can leave this one. Yeah, the old 76er is not working for me. Steak sounds good though. No games. That may have been the table we just left. No, it wasn't. But we may have been left it recently anyway. Nope. Okay. Yeah, I have a feeling this guy might be an aggro tard here. And might be a really good seat for us. Come on, man, where's the good games? It's Friday. Bring on the fish, please. It's like they're all at 100 NL. Let's try this one. Might be good. Got a short stack here. So I think we're gonna get value one more street from a nine. So I think he bets if we check and he has a nine. So now I just think we go for one street of value here. I'm sure a nine calls us, right? Nope. So I guess in a vacuum we'll fold this spot. Although I think people do this wide nowadays. But he's not a full stack, so he's not necessarily a reg. Okay. I got a feeling these guys might be fish, so I'm gonna open 10-9 in the hijack. It's not really a feeling. I mean, this guy's 50-17. I've seen this guy do a couple of crazy, well, maybe not crazy stuff, but did a couple of things. Do I c-bet this? Ace high board. I guess I don't get the opportunity. I mean, that would be typical for this type of player, though. Sometimes these type of players, when they just make a hand, they just bet, you know. They don't check to the razor. But you know, he'll, next time that happens, or if that happens and we have him beat, he'll just overplay his hand too. So yeah, it works out. What are you limping? This guy's stealing 2 for 2. I think we can defend the 8-9-8 here. It's hard for us to rep an ace as a short stack, blind versus blind, so I guess we have to fold. I mean, that's a pretty good spot to raise against a non-thinking player, but we don't know that about him. Do they really both fold? Darn. Do we bet? Nah, just check. It's in the three people. Sometimes it just checks down anyway, and we're good. Sometimes we improve. Sometimes they bet and we fold. Here comes the 5 of hearts. That would have been a tough spot. Right? I'm gonna lead with our open ender, try to take it down here with 4 high. This guy's 167, that's it for 3 hands. We hit the nuts. This guy just gonna bet every time. I think so. I think he just looks like the player that's gonna bet every time. And now hopefully he commits with a 10 or like a flush draw. Did we shove or do we just raise? I think we have to raise because, I mean shove, because we want him to just call. We don't want him just to call $2 with a flush draw, right? We want him to put it all in with a flush draw. And he's never folding a 10 here. May call with a 5 or 6, so. Or he could just have crap and the hand was going to be over anyway. Right? So, I don't know. Kind of unfortunate, he just probably didn't have anything there. This hand plays really good post-flop. This guy's 50-13 though, and he hasn't 3-bet yet, so I think he's just gonna... We don't want to just hit a 10 here and have to commit. Do we just bet 250 and fold? Shoved, maybe shove favorable rivers, I don't know. Check back a lot of rivers. Be happy that we won. I think a 10's a much better card than a queen was there, but I'll just take the win. It's a little bit loose of a table, so I'm going to bet 3x here instead of the normal 2x open. Even though I still expect this to be like a three-way pot every time, right? Minimum. But I still rather build a bigger pot with what is surely the best hand against all these calling ranges. Just gonna increase our profit over time, so. And if we get folds, we get folds. Probably should stay on that table, right? That looked like it might have been a good table. Kind of just in a bad habit now of leaving too soon. I keep forgetting that we're bankrolled enough to not be nitty at 50 and L now. So the nit guy 3-bets us. Okay. And the 4-bet, I expect this to be like aces or kings here, right? Ace-king? He just flats. He's probably got tens, jacks, queens. Ace-king, maybe? That range is doing pretty good on that board. Except for the ace-king part. There's jacks. Ace-king. It's a pretty terrible raise if he actually had jacks. I mean, this could also be aces. Right? Or even kings. I think this is a good spot to do this. Kids, 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 banging at the door. We have a 5 SPR here against a loose player. I think that's just good enough to commit versus this player type. I mean, I think he's bluffing a lot, so I'm just going to call and we'll play a turn. I think it just checks down a lot. Or he has a 7. Yeah, I'm just folding. I mean, this player could be bad enough to do this with like 4-5, right? I mean, this could certainly be 5-7, right? That was just getting it on the flop, 8-7. So, I mean, it's sometimes a bluff, but we got one of the worst turn cards in the world. And yeah, it was a bluff. What are we going to do, though? I guess maybe we just shove the turn? I don't know. Seems like we're only getting called by better there, though. I mean, I guess we could have just hero called the river there, but I don't know. I just think he's going to have two pair there a lot and just think he has the nuts. Don't know. It's kind of just a shit turn card, because basically any turn card I'm committing on except for that one, the one that makes it 4 to a straight. So it's just a really good turn card for him, bad turn card for us. The only turn card we don't put the money in on. I mean, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 5, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king, ace, we put the money in. Of course, king, jack, he wins, but whatever. It's irrelevant. Yeah, down 2 buy-ins on this table. I have 2 overs and a clean gut shot, so we'll bet. Or call. It's a good result for the fish to double up. Not double up, but just win it all in. This is close, but we'll fold. I mean, we're just too short to do anything but this. I think we do this. I think we'll just do a normal raise. A little bit too early to do the commit thing now. We could still fold to a 3-bet from these players, so. We're not folding to a 3-bet from this guy, though. We're just going to ship if he 3-bets. Comes the float or the raise. Oh, it's kind of a high mid board. I expect them to have like worse or better pairs than us here that might fold, so that would be good. Could also just have like ace high too. Might be worth a lead here. We do potentially have some outs. And I think we can just get folds on this flop. Ugh. Now we could definitely have the best hand. But we can't do anything. We just have to check fold. You bastard. Putting that card out there. Freaking poker gods. I'm just going to assume this guy flopped a flush. Or it has an 8 for a chop anyway. Wow. Good fold for us. That could have, I mean, that if that hadn't been 3 clubs on the board, that would have been bad. Because we would have led the turn. He would have just got a better straight. Had a better straight, whatever. Dodged a bullet. I think this guy's going to just have a 7 here most of the time. He's not going to fold the 6s, 5s. He's not going to fold anything, so. Yeah, I think we have to raise here, protect our hand, and see what's going on. Could suck if he, like, shoves 5-6 here, but he's basically ahead if he's got 5-6, so wouldn't be the worst fold in the world. Guess we have to either shove or fold here, so we'll fold. So does he just have a 3 that he lamped? When he tank raises, I'm just folding. I'll check this one back. Makes the turn pretty easy to play. We can have the best hand. Just protect our hand, maybe get him off ace high. We go for thin value here? Probably not. This guy leave? I guess so. I guess we leave now. Take our $8 and limp away. I don't think it's a good spot to call just because these guys are tight behind me, so. Just 3-bet. Darn it. At least call. Just fold. Man, these fish are folding preflop. Four hands trapped on this table. Still a good table. I mean, this guy's still here. Welcome to those joining the stream. Still got about 30 minutes left. We're hoping to run better for the last 30 minutes here. Because we're certainly down this session, I would imagine. I think I can just pretend like I got the button here because these guys are like never playing. So, this guy's 6-0 over 17 hands. He hasn't raised yet. And I have a fish in the blind, so it's a good spot. He's going to pick up his first hand. Gut shot and a flush draw. Not really a great flush draw. Do we just bet here? I don't know. Maybe just check this one back. Play a turn. If this guy wasn't on the button, I would probably think about opening that. But I don't really want a multi-way pot with that hand. Do this against this guy. This guy might frustration shove with like ace 10, king queen, king jack, maybe any pair. Or he can just fold too, that's good. Plus he had one of those hands that I'm dominating. Okay. Did this guy limp? Oh. Gotta get the heads in the right place. Yeah, he limped. Okay, so he limped queen six. That guy must be fishy. I think we can just take this down most of the time. We do have backdoor diamonds as a backup plan, or a 10 could be good in case he has a 7. That's definitely some dead money we can go after. It's a big pot, 25 an L. This guy must have just had an overpair. Pocket nines. Don't want to get bluff raised, so we're going to bet a little bit bigger here. This guy's pretty nitty. I don't want to get floated by like hands that have a lot of equity, like ace high. I'd rather just take it down now. Or at least make him pay a premium if he wants to float with that kind of hand. I think we can do this. I don't remember the last time we had a set, do you guys? When we were actually involved in the hand. Now we get one of these boards we can't continue on because this guy called. I think we can protect though. We're gonna bet small. This guy can certainly continue with a worse hand. Or he could check shove. I don't know, man. I mean, best case scenario, he has like 6 outs. Gut shots or something. This guy's calling every time, isn't he? Darn. maybe I can open that. This guy can fold one time. Not if it's the end of the world if I end up multi-way with that hand. You have to have some strong hands in your range when you ISO. You know, this guy might hate me now. Yeah, I could see this happening with worse. I'm definitely not folding. If he has a better hand than me right now, because I kind of expected him maybe to do this, so that's kind of one of the reasons I ISO'd. So now that he does what I wanted him to do, if he has a hand that beats ace queen suited, this is just a cooler. Damn. I'd expect him to be that strong. But we went a $34 pot. That's good. I mean, I expect him to do that with a really wide range like ace jack, ace 10, king queen, king jack, any pocket pairs. So against that range, ace queen suited is doing excellent. This is just like full steam ahead here. Yeah, he's gonna have some worse aces for sure. So we're just gonna ship the turn. If he has 5-6, he might continue. If he has king queen, he might continue. I mean, he could definitely have that for a float. That may be our second biggest pot. So that's good. We had a $43 pot that we got at M7030 a couple days ago, right? And lost. Yeah, we started this challenge with $25, so it's nice to have 35 on one table. We'll limp if this guy limps. Try to see a flop. Yeah, why not? We're deep. Deep for us. I think this guy's a little bit too tight. Yeah, we'll call this. Yeah, we're in that table. We're in a hand with a fish, and this guy probably has a tight enough range that if we did connect really hard to this flop, we can win a giant pot here. So I like my call at the $1.50. I think it's fine. Yeah, we'll be disciplined. Just play this straightforward. I think we play this slow. This guy's just basically going to have a lot of set mines in his range. So we don't want to get it in versus a set here, and it's very unlikely somebody has a set now. Or a three of a kind. But we could certainly can get value from sevens, something like that now. And I think we can get two streets of, from it, can we? I think I'm gonna do this to get calls by something like sevens, and to maybe induce a bluff from, like, I don't know, some kind of busted diamond draw. Yeah, didn't work out for us, but we still won the pot. Just play this straightforward. I think we've had the flat here. Or actually, technically, we're the button there. We could have shoved that. It's fine either way. We'll check back, try to pick up some equity, which we do. We pick up fours, clubs, ace or king. Is now probably an out most of the time. So we can definitely confidently bet this turn or call if somebody leads. I think we do still have some showdown value, and it's highly unlikely he's going to fold any piece of this board. So, wow, slow played. Good for you. He's definitely not folding that. I think we just bet and protect our hand. We're probably good here. We could definitely get check called by like ace, jack, king, queen, something like that here. This guy might just be confident now that he won with a set or something, or was it this guy? I don't remember which one it was. Anyway, he's 150. Over two hands, maybe he just ISOs like any two here, I don't know. Here we get what we want. I expect this guy's gonna fold a lot, and this guy's just gonna call with like ace jack plus, king queen, king jack, any pair. Oh wow, okay, we'll take this. Wow, no free rolls, please. We're both free rolling. Now he's free rolling, no! Woo, if we could have got a diamond on the turn. We got him. It kind of sucks that he had ace king, because I think he plays it the same exact freaking way with ace queen or ace jack. It was a fun hand, though. Yeah, I think this guy's just a freaking maniac. This just sucks, man. I can't really call, and I can't really shove. I don't think he's going to raise this much and then fold. I mean, he could have to jack 10 here, but we're screwed if he does. Fortunate. Why did this table not work? Okay. We definitely like having this guy in the seat. He's not, well, he is directly on our left technically, but I just think it sets up a lot of profitable spots. I mean, we can't really limp, because he kind of knows what we're doing when we limp. Like, he can't just raise now that I limped, unless he has a strong hand, because he saw us have ace-king. Although, maybe he's just not paying attention and is dumb and does it anyway, I don't know. Yeah. Are we good? Nope. Hey, thank you for the follow, Deja Vu. I appreciate that. Thanks for joining us. Did you watch my sorry punk ass try to build my bankroll by playing a short stack? It was going well until this month. This month has not been good to us. We're not down. Well, maybe we are after today. But we're certainly not tearing it up. I think our EV win rate's something like 3 big blinds this month. And we're actually, we were, well, before last session we were down in cash, but up in sit and goes. But we're going to keep pounding, I guess, and see what happens. But yeah, thank you for the follow. Getting kid aggro right now. It wants me to come downstairs so they can I can see their new toys that mama bought them. But I'll be done in 14 minutes, so we can do that then. They're into trolls now. I have three girls. We saw the troll movie, and yep. First it was Anna and Elsa, the princesses. Then it was Shopkins. Well, it's still Shopkins. And now it is trolls. I'm just glad to be done with this Frozen thing, you know? I mean, it was bad. For a long time, it was nothing but Frozen this, Frozen that. This guy's pretty tight, so I think we just 3-bet. We're gonna do small, though, just in case he's not strong and can call. And we're committing on any flop. Okay, we'll take that. Yeah, this is a good result. Well, it's a good situation. We'll see if it's a good result. Okay. We double up. It's a small double up. Hey, we have kings again. Could we finish this strong or what? Could be good. We'll certainly complete with the queen 10 suited here. This guy is, oh, we only have four hands, so. I think the standard play is just either shove or raise small. Just do that. This guy doesn't have to have a heart. I'm actually going to protect my hand, and I don't want to get bluffs, so I'm just going to bet again. I think we can check this back. This guy might be aggro enough to lead the turn. I think we can raise a lot of turns. But now that we make a showdown value hand, well, certainly we're going to bet now. We would just call. We're going to lead this. They don't have to have ace high. We can just win right now. And we can certainly improve to a well-disguised straight. So we want to bet. And of course, winning is always good. We have about 10 minutes left. I think we have time to pull up another table. Don't get me wrong, I like toys. When I was a kid, I collected Transformers. What else? I don't even know. D-Land, home of Stetson, right? I think I had a basketball camp there 1 year. Maybe my sophomore year. Now we just check. And we win! That's a good bonus surprise there. I didn't expect to be good there that often, but he certainly could have worse 10s in his range. So I expect worse pairs I don't know. That's basically all that could be in his range, right? Maybe he picked up a flush draw on the turn, too. Yeah, he had a flush draw on the turn, but he had 9 high? Otherwise, what the hell is he doing? He called 2 bets with his hand. Thank you. I certainly want to play pots with you. Try and pick up this pot here. Why not? This guy would have led with something. This guy might call with 9 high and we're still good. I guess we're done with this hand. A jack or a 10 could be good here, but we're not going to bet again. That could be a good card to bluff at, but we're not going to do it because we know this guy is like a super calling station. And we just know that's not plus EV. Yeah, this guy's not folding an 8, probably. So I like our check give up. No tables. No tables worth sitting at. Trying to get called by small pairs. That's what the shove means right here. Yeah, losing loved ones definitely sucks. Sucks big time. My mom lives in Florida. By the way, she's in Leesburg, which isn't too far from DeLand. Pick up some equity here, but I don't think we'll bet. We could have the best hand anyway, so no point. He definitely could have Jack 9. Not likely. But he's not going to fold anything now anyway, so we'll just check it back. He might call that too. So we have, what time is it? Anybody know? I can't see my clock. The clock's blocked. Yeah, we have 5 minutes. If we're gonna be in the big blind quickly, I could pull a couple tables up here. Maybe this one. We'll see if we're in the blind soon. Nah. Okay, we don't have any real tables here, so. Actually, we'll just go ahead and maybe we'll play. Yeah, we'll play one more time around on these tables. Why not? think this is a good spot for this. Lots of limpers. They could definitely call with worse, or they could just miss the flop and fold the flop. Lots of good things can happen here, except for getting trapped. That could happen too. This guy is 17-0. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. It worked out though. Oh, I thought I checked here. Yeah, jumping out of planes anytime does not appeal to me. I mean, I'm assuming it would be thrilling, right? But I think I could just do virtual reality nowadays, right? And get maybe some of the same rush. I don't know. I tend not to do. I guess maybe driving a car is more dangerous than jumping out of an airplane, though, right? But a whole hell of a lot less scary most of the time. I don't know. I drive in Charlotte. It can be pretty scary here. So we'll be done here. And here. Soon. We'll see how we did. Hopefully we're not down too much today. We made some ground up yesterday from our bad play, well, bad play probably, but bad variance anyway. So we started at 676, right? In that range. So if we're anywhere above 650, I'll be happy today. Any day now. But yeah, I'm getting some major aggro from the kids, so I better run downstairs as soon as this finishes. Okay, 9-8 suited. We could play that maybe. Maybe. I think we ran better this last 20 or 30 minutes. Maybe we made up a little bit of our losses for this session. You know, if we could just run bad and almost break even, I mean, that's like a huge victory, right? But I'm not saying we're breaking even. We're probably down like 20, but I'm usually wrong on that. I'm pretty bad at predicting. I'm just going to give up here. Screw him and his min-bet crap. I may just leave in the hijack. Come on, people. Yeah, I have a delay just because, you know, somebody could be watching the stream, jump on the tables I'm playing on, see my whole cards. It'd be pretty easy to play against me if they knew my whole cards, you know. So we do have a delay. For that reason, I don't like having a delay. I mean, whatever though, right? Kind of a necessary evil. I mean, I could hide the table name, and it would help, and I probably could get away with, like, no delay, or maybe just a one-minute delay, but I don't know, there's some pretty persistent people out there who probably could hunt me down. We don't want to chance that, right? Is this guy min-bet with, trips? which is good for us. I'm gonna open this one because this guy, these guys look fishy, so. Okay, so we're done no matter what happens here. What, baby? I'm coming. Alright, that was my 4-year-old telling me to come down. So I'm gonna have to do that. Let's close it out here, see how we did. I have to move it in because I cannot see it. Okay, $670. So we're down like $6 today. Big whoop, right? If you had watched the first hour of this session, you would know how good it is to only be down $6. We ran bad, we lost all the all-ins, you know, etc., etc. So I'm pretty happy to only be down a little bit. So tomorrow's another day. We'll see you at the normal time, I think. Maybe a little early. I may do the 2:30 to 4:30 thing again. But yeah, thanks everybody for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks to the new people for following the stream. I hope you'll come back and see us again as we continue to try and get this stinking bankroll going that way, right? So, okay. Well, thanks everybody. Have a good day.